This one goes out to all the DI highs. Oh, sweet, sweet baby. Well, everybody knows the models go, won't go broke. Ain't nobody wanna see black radical lesbians on the screen. Get this bullshit out of here. Sweet baby Black Rock got a stain on me. Creative bankruptcy. Leading to more ESG.
Take the booba. They take the booba out, out, yeah. Take the booba. They take the booba out of our games.
I just realized that. I don't want to play anymore. I'm off time now. F*** this. That's the little piece I decided to write when they served me a moldy sandwich in this prison cell. I hope you liked it.
It's horrible.
Granted, you have talent.
It's called Sweet Baby Blues. And thus begins the Blues Tanga arc. I've decided to sell my soul on the crossroads. I'm done. There isn't a single video game I'm legitimately looking forward to anymore. When you realize how much power companies like BlackRock have in the industry, everything feels completely hopeless. It's not even really an uphill battle. It's like trying to tear down an entire mountain with your bare hands. We simply lack the tools to combat something like DEI and ESG scores. The most folks like you and me can do, really, is voice our concerns and pray the gay away. And that's about it, really. Sometimes that gets done. For as much as I beat myself over the head saying I'm just wasting my time telling gamers all of this, warning them ahead of time, because they're all gonna go and hate watch or hate buy something anyway, just to see for themselves, that wasn't the case with Suicide Squad Kill the Justice League. This time around, gamers actually decided they were gonna keep their wallets closed.
Warner Brothers says the failure of Suicide Squad Kill the Justice League contributed to a $200 million hit to revenue.
Now comes the part where we throw our heads back and laugh. Ready?
Ready!
Suicide Squad Kill the Justice League has disappointed Warner Bros. Discovery, owner of developer Rocksteady, to the tune of a $200 million hit to revenue. Reporting in its quarter one financial results, Warner Bros. Discovery said its games revenue declined significantly as a result of a tough comparison with last year's best-selling video game, Hogwarts Legacy. Suicide Squad, Kill the Justice League, generated significantly lower revenues compared with those generated by Hogwarts Legacy. During the same three-month period, the company said. In a follow-up investor-focused call, Warner Bros. Discovery boss David Zaslav called the release of Suicide Squad Kill the Justice League disappointing. Before Warner Bros. Discovery chief financial officer Gunnar Wedenfels detailed an impairment charge the company absorbed as a result of a game's failure.
Just? $200 million? Really? That's it? That's not good enough for me. I demand better. I demand satisfaction. But I'll take it for now. Seriously, what the hell were you thinking, Warner Bros? You really took one look at Suicide Squad and you thought to yourselves, we have a Hogwarts Legacy in the making here? Really? Well, your first mistake was using Hogwarts Legacy as a measuring stick. That game's success, regardless of, you know, it being shafted at the award show, is not something that happens too frequently. I guess in Warner Bros. Head, they thought to themselves, yeah, the Suicide Squad and the Justice League have the potential to match Harry Potter's success as a video game, which, honestly, it did have the ability to do that. The problem is, the game sucks. Not to mention, Hogwarts Legacy had an active boycott against it by a pitiful, like, 0.001% of the human population, whose group I'm not going to name. So off the bat, Hogwarts Legacy had a lot going for it, but when it came to Suicide Squad, not a single person I could name you on this planet was hyping the game up. The minute it was presented to me, there was an LGBT flag within like the first 10 seconds of the trailer. So I knew what to expect, and people were gaslighting me. They said, Frit, the LGBT flag doesn't mean anything. I'm like, well, if it doesn't mean anything, why does it have to be shoved down my face in the first 10 seconds of a video game trailer? But most importantly, the game had consultation from the infamous SBI. Right off the bat, there was no hope for this game. It was everything wrong with video games. And I mean that wholeheartedly. Everything wrong with video games. An always online live service / single player experience. 9 hours long. $70. A complete butchering and massacre of beloved characters and wokeness plastered all over the game, with its greatest flaw actually being the writing. And believe me, I had a hard time deciding what was the worst thing about this game. The gameplay, the format, the content itself? It was pretty hard to decide, but it all narrows down to the writing, the weakest aspect. And a lot of that is thanks to the contributions of a very specific company with a big green baby logo, who were so generously credited with names of some absolutely terrible people you may recognize on social media. People with a lot of hate in their heart towards, you know, white folks.
The industry, you need to be able to talk to people in the industry, and you need to be able to understand how the industry works, who will favor you, etc. I am clearly not a white person. I am clearly not a white man. I'm a Black non-binary woman. So it was pretty difficult for me because a lot of people did not take me seriously when I first joined the industry, which I think is kind of crazy because I'm making a game just like everyone else. So why wouldn't you take me seriously? Like, is it because I'm Black? I mean, it probably is. But like, you know what I mean? Like, it's just, it kind of sucks that people saw me and are just like, whatever, we're not gonna take her seriously. But if a white man made Validate, it would be fucking everywhere. That game would be everywhere.
So I am ecstatic to hear that the game was a complete failure. I wish it was an even bigger failure. That's the only thing that can make me happier. Warner Brothers deserves to lose money. Warner Brothers deserves to not succeed with a game like this. No company on this planet should be succeeding trying to get away with pushing games like this. It's a plague to the industry, a stain on such a beloved hobby. And these corporations don't care unless it makes no money. Then they start to care. So it's crucial that going forward, more projects like this continue to flop and companies continue to lose out on a lot of revenue. The time for rewarding mediocrity is over. Well, at the very least, it should be. Now, we cannot go on without thanking a very specific Steam curator page for contributing to helping keep gamers informed on which companies are infesting these video games. You know who I'm talking about, Cabrutus and the Sweet Baby Detector on Steam. And that is why people within the industry hate the Steam curator page. They hate that there is a tool designed to keep gamers informed. So it should come as absolutely no surprise that the Discord of the creator of the SBI detected curator page was hacked.
Sweet Baby Ink Detected was just hacked as of a little while ago. I have been banned from this server myself, as well as many other content creators. They have also deleted the content creator page that had thousands of images of receipts against pro-DEI lunatics. Don't worry, everything will be gotten back. Statement below. Attention, everyone. I am DEI Detected Worldwide PR. Our Discord server, Sweet Baby Ink Detected, just got attacked from a hacker. Many people were banned out of no reason at all. We are working on fixing the issue. We will get everything up and running as fast as possible. And we apologize for the issue. Thanks. Make sure we all support @Cabrutus during this time as they fix the server and restore it.
Without question, this is a targeted hacking. You know, without a shadow of a doubt, it's that specific audience who from the very beginning was trying to take down Cabrutus' Steam page and account. That crowd is relentless, and they've been known to DDoS. So I find it completely reasonable to believe the agenda behind this hacking and the maliciousness of it. But this is how desperate they are, resorting to hacking. Now, luckily for me, I was able to get a hold of Cabrutus, and well, I think I'll just let the man himself say what happened.
We're gonna start over everything?
Oh, well, we'll just start, I'm recording now. We'll start, here's how I'll open it up. So, Cabrutus, I heard you were a part of some hacking. Somebody's after you?
Well, looks like, right? I mean, I don't know if they are after me, but definitely after what the infos I have, you know.
Because, yeah, and we have no confirmation of who did it, correct? So like, we're not able to pinpoint the target.
No,
but no, the hacker and what they were trying to do was very much an attack on the Sweet, yes, Baby Curator page, right? Or the
yeah,
Discord.
Yeah. Yeah, the Discord server, yes. It was something, I mean, the hacker knew what he was doing, because he only had a few minutes in server, I'm not sure, but anyway, a few minutes in the server, and yet I managed to nuke the main information related channels we had on the Discord.
Jesus, we had a channel, Christ!
We had a channel to store receipts. We had a channel for content creators to share infos and make content together, you know, about Gamergate 2. And we had a channel for game developers, and they were actually developing a indie game inside inside there.
Oh, wow, that is even scummier! Wow!
Yeah, and and also, he managed to ban like 2,000 people, 2,000 random people from the server. So, dude, if you are listening to this, and you got banned, I'm sorry, but I mean, you lost the hacker, probably.
Jesus, so they went in there, and they deleted very important channels. They
only
removed
the important ones.
And they removed a bunch of users. So, I mean, it's to me, it's clear as day, the person who did this to you does not agree with what you're doing.
Yes.
And they're taking a stand against it, and this is a attack. And like I said, no names can be given out, and that's wise not to do on your part. And I highly respect you for, you know, not wanting to blame the one crowd that's on everybody's mind, obviously. But
yes, I don't want to be unfair to anyone, even if that means that I'm those people, right? People. I don't want to be unfair even to them. So yeah, my moderator, Mr. Arceus, thanks to this guy, he's a hero, you know. So he noticed what was happening to the server, and well, he banned the bad guy. He banned it. He's doing his best to unban the people that got banned. But don't worry, you know, regarding all the info that they deleted. Yes, of course, we lost some data, but we have backups of most of the important ones.
So the immediate channels that were attacked were some of the most important ones, you said, right?
And yes. Only them, by the way. Just only them, bro.
The
hacker knew exactly what he was doing.
Exactly, yeah. So this hacker definitely has something against all of this. I guarantee it was like, you know, just that person's own doing. and their own reasoning. I doubt this was like coordinated by a mob. That person was looking to put a, you know, a stop, or at the very least a dent into everything you're doing. And that's just wild.
It was exactly because someone tried to silence me. So this isn't new for me. And I just want to make clear, I'm not afraid. You know, this doesn't make me think about, you know, okay, it's better if I just stop. It's better. No, man. No, I'm not afraid. I mean, not at all.
I'll keep doing what I'm doing.
Yeah. In fact, I will double down. You know, I will double down. I will make the best I can to make it big.
That's the right mentality to have. Your Discord mods are you? Did you guys recognize the account doing this? Was it a person who was a part of that Discord for a while, or did they just jump in and then start doing all this stuff?
Well, that's an excellent question, actually, because we think it was. You think it was because in order to get the account in and give the account a role, which the account could do the damage that it did, it definitely had to be someone who was inside already, or they hacked someone's account. You know, they stole someone's account that was an admin to the server. But if that was the case, I could talk to the guys and I would be known. So it's really hard to say.
I know that there are plants.
Yes.
When I see them posting about your Discord, because they post screenshots like, this is from the SBI curator Discord, you know? I see them post that stuff. So I'm like, okay, they are in your Discord. They are watching. You know, I'm loving this because this is just, this is the biggest Uno card gamers have ever pulled on the industry, and I'm all here for it. I love how the industry had no problem when, like, you know, people like Adam Sessler would go out there and say, like, he wants to dox, like, people who are racist and stuff like that. Or journalists directly quoting people, you know, users in their articles and things like that. And it's amazing because gamers are like, you know what? We can play that game too. Hey, this is who worked on this game. And they're like, don't say anything. I'm like, why? Why? What are you scared of? Aren't you proud of the projects you worked on?
Well, I'll just say this, community managers, you guys better start doing your work correctly. You guys better start acting good.
I personally don't find it hard to believe the specific crowd we're all thinking of would go to that extent. Fortunately, we have no evidence to fully back that up. For all we know, it could just be a troll, but anybody can say they're trolling as well. There's a reason specific channels were taken down on that Discord. There was a goal, and that was to sabotage it. Someone out there has it out for SBI detected. Now, you know, I don't want to get all conspiratorial on you, but with how things are turning out, with these SBI games completely flopping like Zao and Suicide Squad, you begin to wonder, maybe is there a financial incentive to silencing Cabrutus? Not hard to believe, not far-fetched. And I don't think it's any specific company, because now the reoccurring thought is SBI is bad for business. If you associate with them, if they worked on your game, I will not buy it. That right there is enough incentive to try and silence Cabrutus. And yet in spite of that, the man is not scared in the slightest, so shout out to him. Being hacked is no fun. I think many of us have been there, especially if what's being hacked is something that takes hours of your day and you put a lot of love and effort into. I think it's just important to make everyone here aware of what's going on, because if you are a part of that Discord, keep your eyes open, help toughen security, don't let these jackasses have an inch, because sometimes that's all they need. And all I need from you is a like, a comment, a share, but most importantly, a subscription. Make my dreams come true. I want to hit that 80K. If I can one day just hang a plaque on my wall, I'll feel like I've done something instead of wasting my talents on a platform with decreasing attention spans. So, that being said, I'll see you in the next one.
Free Congo sucks ass.